Hi there. You will probably be wondering why I'm speaking in English. Give me a few seconds or skip until this second. The main reason is that English has become a language of great influence in our modern days. It doesn't matter from which country you are. English is present in education, entertainment, and even jobs. You will need to learn English sooner or later. And that's why I decided to make 2 videos in English per month. The first Sunday and penultimate Thursday of every month.
Not a big deal, right?
Once I said this, let's start with the video. I am 100% sure that you have a sprite like this in your house. And if it is the case, I encourage you to take it and read the side letters. First, you will notice that any sprite has in capital letters a warning of not exposing it to higher temperatures than 50 Celsius or 122 Fahrenheit. But let me ask you something. Do you know what will happen if you don't obey this warning? So get comfortable wherever you are, because we're gonna explain this. Let's start! As we mentioned in other videos, the pressure is the ratio between the perpendicular force applied in a specific area, and the temperature is the measurement of the kinetic energy. The thing is that pressure and temperature are all combined along with the volume. It is essential to mention that we are working with gases. The sprite that you have in your hand at this moment expels a specific gas. The content of the can is partially liquid due to the pressure that exists inside. But if we decide to exert more pressure inside the can, the volume will decrease. We can take all the day long doing this experiment, increasing the pressure and writing the data of the new volume. And if we join all this information, we're gonna get a graph like this. That's precisely what Robert Boyle did hundreds of years ago. He discovered that the relationship between the volume and the pressure is inversely proportional, meaning that if we increase the pressure, we decrease the volume. If we analyze the graphic, it is similar to a reciprocal function. In fact, it is a reciprocal function, but we don't care about the other side of the function, because pressure and volume will take negative values. The formula of a reciprocal function is y equal to 1 over x. In this case, the x-axis is the volume expressed in liters, and the y-axis is the pressure. So let's try something. What if we replace these values into the formula? We will have that the pressure is equal to 1 over the volume. Yeah, that will work. But just for a specific case, the thing is that with gases we can have similar graphs like this, but not the same. The answer to this problem is adding a constant to the formula. Therefore, we will have a graph that adjusts to our purposes. If I multiply it by 2, it will look like this. If I do it by 3, like this, and so on, so on, so on. The only thing that I need to do is to determine the pressure in a specific volume, and to be sure that the temperature and the mass remain constant. The special part of this is that we can express the formula as the pressure times the volume is equal to a constant. I can pick 2 points of the graph, and both will be equal to the constant. And if I equal both equations, boom, I will leave with a masterpiece like this. An equation that relates the initial volume with the initial pressure with the next volume with the next pressure. So let's suppose that my sprite has a pressure of 5 atm. The label over here says that volume is of 400 milliliters, or equal to 0.4 liters. So if I want to know the volume that this content will have in a normal pressure of 1 atm, so if I replace the values in the formula and I solve it, I know that the volume of this content will be of 2 liters at a pressure of 1 atm. Amazing, right? But now we are going to proceed with the third value. Yes, the temperature. The relationship between the volume and the temperature results to be so much simpler than the last one. The relationship between these two values is directly proportional, meaning that if we increase the temperature, we also increase the volume. So we will have a linear function like this, expressed by y is equal to mx plus b. B is going to be 0 since the intersection between the x-axis and the y-axis is 0. In this case, the x-axis is the temperature in Kelvin and the y-axis is the volume. So, as in the last case, we replace these values into the formula. Here, the slope is the constant of our function, and we can change it to our benefit. And great, we have that the volume is equal to a constant times the temperature. But we can also express this as the volume over the temperature is equal to a constant. And remember that we're talking of a constant that is equal in 2 points of the graph. So if we pick 2 points of the graph, they have the same slope or the same constant. And as we did in the last case, we can equal both equations, leaving with another formula, where the initial volume over the initial temperature is equal to the final volume over the final temperature. And here it comes the warning. The volume is 0.4 liters at a temperature of 27 Celsius. That is approximately 300 Kelvin. But if we raise the temperature to 50 Celsius, that will be 323 Kelvin. What will be the volume? And if we do the math and replace it on the formula, we got that the final volume is 0.43 liters. Well, it doesn't seem too much, but remember that these cans are made to support a specific quantity of pressure and volume. So if we exceed the limits, it will probably explode. If you want to learn more about chemistry and physics in a funny way, I recommend you to subscribe to my channel. It is free, and I also recommend you to watch one of my latest videos. I hope you enjoyed the video and give me some thumbs up if you like it. See you later!